Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Akron is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. Yeah. Gathered in at the six. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. Clipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
Three down. Mike three. Fumble. Motion.
Caught with room to work. He's knocked out of bounds right around the 22-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Bring him down behind the line.
I love to see this, Brad. These cornerbacks have the toughest job in college football, and that's to cover some of the fastest players on the field, the receivers. And for a corner willing to come up, get off of his block, and make a play to disrupt the run, that's as good as it gets if you're a defensive coordinator.
They'll bring him down around the 23-yard line. Well, it depends on where they spotted, but it looks like he was stopped short.
I think so, Brad, and the defense was bending on that play a little too much, but they didn't break.
And they're coming after this punter. He's taken down at the 42-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Quick toss. And down he goes at the 29. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
From the 29-yard line, first down. Setting up the play action. Deep ball, laying it out there. Good job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
From their own 20-yard line. It's first down. Nice run to the outside. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Knight, the return man. Knight fields it at the 38. Brought down at the 44. An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
There's a strike complete. He's taken down at the 50-yard line. First from the 50. It's second down. With the pass, incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
He's on the run. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He fields a punt at the 20. Oh, man, he took him down hard. You know, a lot of people in college football might find these types of games boring, but you look at the start of this game, this is good old-fashioned football, partner.
I agree with you, Brad. I think sometimes you look at games, and if it's sloppy offense, that's one thing. But when you see two defenses go out and play with a great deal of emotion and dominate a football game, sign me up for that every time.
Fires out to his wideout, and they make the stop at the 31-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
Tackled after a decent pickup. So we got a few yards on that carry.
If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Has some daylight. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Too easy, too easy.
Slings it. The catch and gets out of bounds.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
Runs outside for a nice gain. Second down and 5. Ball on the 40-yard line. Strike. Tackle made around the 38-yard line. Scrambling around. He's at the 30. Diving for extra yardage. At about the 15-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Wimberly picks them up about 5 yards on that pass play, and that one will move the sticks.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the touchdown, Falcons. They decided to go to the running back on that touchdown pass.
Just a nice job by the quarterback of showing great patience here, going through his progressions, finally finding the back to get into the end zone.
He hits the PAT. An 11-play, 76-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown.
Bowling Green ready to kick this one off from the 5-yard line. Tackle made at the 27. Bowling Green's defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, that's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
He's got his man across the middle. Down at the 43.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. And he's taken down right around the 46-yard line. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
I'm a huge fan of the play-action pass in college football because the play-action, it really puts a lot of pressure on defense. The defense gets caught up and concerned about the running game, and it puts them out of position. And it makes the throwing lanes for the quarterback and the windows that he's trying to find much easier to
caught. Touchdown, Zips.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 72-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
We're even at seven in this one, and he's hammered down. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. I like the idea of trying to drop that one in there, but that one might have had a little too much air under it.
I don't have a problem with the pass. It was just a superb job by the defender playing the ball in the air.
He's tackled around the 39-yard line. They get nice yardage on that run. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. Good open field tackle. Tackles him for a loss.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen. Maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. We played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Goes right. Picked off. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
From the 46-yard line, first down. Now he tries to buy some time. Slides down. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. He's going to try and scramble. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. To the 10. What a play. Knocked out of bounds, and that's going to be first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Defense stacked in tight here. They go with a run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
Still 8 yards away. Now it's third and goal. Flips it middle to the running back. And he is drilled at the 8-yard line. Akron is looking to go up by three. It's up, and the field goal is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the six. He got hit hard. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Three down, three down. Mike three.
He scrambled. And down he goes at the 15. Quarterback picked up a yard at best there on the scramble. He's scrambling, and he's tackled at the 20. He's hit and taken down. The middle. They try running left. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. He's scrambling. He's taken down.
Right around the 44-yard line.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Up the middle for a nice gain. And they'll bring him down behind the line. It's the ninth play of the drive. Throws and it's incomplete.
Sometimes when you throw it that hard, you can't control the accuracy all that well. He'll get it under control, though, in time.
Knight, back to return it. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Akron is up a field goal. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. That's a great tackle at the 38-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He fights forward to about the 39. Toss left, taken down behind the line. Rodgers back deep to return. They'll bring him down at the 37.
Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Incomplete, broken up. Good awareness defensively that time by the linebacker.
Not only that, but as you saw, he also made a very athletic move to get to the ball.
From their own 37-yard line, second down, in the shotgun and five wideouts. He goes out of bounds.
Right around the 42-yard line.
The 38.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
He's taken down at the 30. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Akron is up by 3. Now he tries to buy some time. Brought down in the open field. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop at the 46. Check, tight right.
short over the middle.
And he hits him hard at the 47. Akron's going to have to use their second time out of the half. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Throws over the middle. It's intercepted.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. The Falcons taking their first time out of the half.
Man left, man left. Put down, put down.
Easy, easy, easy. Eagle! Eagle!
Let's it go. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Knight is the deep man awaiting the return. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Tackle made right around the 50.
Easy, easy, easy. Kill. Back
up. Akron has a 3-point lead. Around the 42-yard line.
Wants to go long and does. Missed him.
Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. The Zips with a 3-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw, both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they've tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio with the best seat in the house. Belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. And he'll return this one from the 7th. Heading for the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Akron holds a field goal lead. Brought down right around the 32-yard line. From their own 32-yard line. Second down. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down at the 37-yard line.
Man left, man left.
carries the ball for a nice gain. From their own 43-yard line, first down. Runs it right. Nice pickup. The Zips had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. He makes it to the 48-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Might have been some early movement up front. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First and 10. Ball on the 40. Akron is up a field goal. He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack. Here's the eighth play of the series. They work the right side, and there is nothing going there. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Two times. Four down. Mark 55.
He's tackled at the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, second down. They go to the ground game. Runs right for a nice game. Here's the 12th play of the drive. Akron is up by three. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Another third down upcoming, and they've converted all three this drive. Let's it fly. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 4. gets to about the 27-yard line.
Akron's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They come out on an empty backfield. Got his man, can't tack on any yardage. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. From their own 49-yard line, first down.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
To that quickly. Excellent open field tackle. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
They'll bring him down at the 42. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Toss play. He gets hit out of bounds at the 21-yard line. From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
I got two.
Tackled after a decent pickup. It's second and five here. Ball on their own 38. Decent run here, right side. Again with a carry. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line. Rodgers awaiting the return. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He rifles it. And he tackles him hard at the 34. And it's caught.
I think this defense right now doesn't realize if it's going to be a run or a pass. And that's the perfect time to be able to call play action. This defense is on its heels. They're guessing with the offense. That time they guess wrong, and the result is a big play for the offense.
And down he goes at the 25-yard line. He scrambled. He's taken down right around the 16-yard line.
Come on,
10. That's a great tackle at the 7. He's on the run. Slides down to the ground. Throw caught, touchdown.
So this entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
Here's the point after to try to cut this to a three-point game. And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 26. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. Akron has a three-point lead. He fights forward to about the 29. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Zips with a three-point lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They get nice yardage on that run. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. And he's immediately tackled. Fights forward to about the 49. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on their own 49. And they make the stop around the 48-yard line. One away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He's taken down at the 22-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Give to the tailback. Got an opening. And he shoved out of bounds at the 30. Nice run, and he's brought down.
They're giving away free yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Player gets 6 yards on the play. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
him down for a loss on the play. Pretty good defense there on the option. They'll stop him for a loss of one. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. They put everyone up on the line. He's at the 30, to the 10. Touchdown! What a run to take the lead. And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. He's out to the 30. And he's taken down at the 35.
Yeah, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Tackle at the 38. From their own 38-yard line, second down. Nice gain as he works the right side. From their own 48-yard line. First down. He lost the ball. The defense scoops it. Cost him.
At this stage in the game, the number one rule has to be to hold on to the football.
So the question on this one is whether or not the ball carrier's knee hit the ground before the fumble popped loose. The coach wants to challenge this one, so we'll take another look at the possible fumble. Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep, those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
From the 48-yard line, second down. Now he's scrambling. He dives and he'll be marked down. In the middle and nothing there. Second and 10. Ball on the 41. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Draw here. And they'll bring him down behind the line. From the 30-yard line, first down. Almost picked off. And he's taken down at the 29. And here's another third down.
flips it middle to the running back. He's at the 20, and he's level at the 17-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Tackle made at the 15-yard line. It's second down, eight to go. Ball on the 15-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. This is the 10th play of this drive. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Might have been some early movement up front. It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
Third and five now following the defensive penalty. He's got it out to his tight end. He's pushed out of bounds at the 3-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. Brought down just outside the goal line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. From the 1-yard line. Second down. Defense stacked in tight here. He's tackled around the 1-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Akron's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Touchdown, and that's going to give them the lead. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 28.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. Now he tries to buy some time. He'll take it himself. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
We have less than a minute to go.
Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. The Falcons call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He's scrambling. Brought down in the open field. Throws a bullet. Makes a grab and steps out right away. From the 48-yard line, it's first down. He's going to try and scramble. Runs with it, and he's got room. And he's tackled at about the 29-yard line. Finish here today, 24-21, Akron. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.